हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज़ बाय शेठ विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस एंड कॉमर्स। माई सेल्फ जयेश राजगोर एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी 12th स्टैंडर्ड कॉमर्स इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। येस माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी सॉ इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर, वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड विद चैप्टर नंबर 1, एडवांस्ड वेब डिजाइनिंग, अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर फ्रॉम द बोर्ड एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, बोथ इन थियोरी एज वेल एज प्रैक्टिकल। माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस चैप्टर हेल्प्स यू इन understanding or creating the layout of a web page using CSS. Similarly, students, you can learn to design the website. Students, you can also design the web form with validations. Students, you can also learn concept of image mapping and iframe or inline frame. The aim here is to give the skills to create HTML web pages using HTML5. My dear students, we in the previous video lectures of information technology have studied about forms in HTML. You have also studied forms in HTML in 11th standard. We have studied different controls related to form like text, radio, checkbox, submit, reset, select, and text area. These controls are used to collect different kinds of users' inputs such as contact details like name, address, single or multiple options from group of options, as well as clearing and submitting data, etc. My dear students, HTML5 has introduced additional form controls as well. In the previous video lecture, we studied or did practically the form which is available over here, which had fields like name with a text box, then we had email, then we took information regarding date of inception, we also made the user type office time and a range of control at number of years between 1 to 100, and then we also had this submit button created using a PNG image file format. In today's video lecture, my dear students, we are going to discuss about a very important and interesting topic called as the meta tag. Yes, my dear students, the meta tag is a tag in HTML that describes some aspects of contents of a web page. The HTML meta tag is used by search engines to search information. Now, this is a very important, crucial part when you actually create a website to rank the website in the search sections of the search engines. It is important to fill some important metadata into your header section. My dear students, search engine work in such a format that when user types a particular query or asks for a particular question or searches or looks around for a particular thing in the search engine, it should rank related topics to the user. As many a times you search various topics on Google and Google provides you with various content which he has or it has stored on its search engine. Similarly, to make the search engine rank your website, your meta information should be solid in nature, and thus meta tag helps you or helps HTML to describe some aspects of contents of a web page. So let us understand this meta tag in detail. Yes, my dear students, this data is provided within the web page. This is an empty tag, that is a singular tag, which carries information within its attributes. So it means the features or the attributes of this tag is a very important one. Yes, the meta tag is placed between the head and head tags. Metadata will not be displayed on the web page. So this is very clear, my dear students. The information which we put in metadata will never be shown in your output. So you don't get confused ki why exactly the information which I put is not coming in the output. Metadata is not related to your output, but it is related to your web page itself. The content on the web page, the related material on the web page, the information which you put in the metadata will be given to the search engine, and the search engine will optimize them to rank your web pages and show the users it when they search about certain content from your web page. Let us now today understand some important attributes of meta tag. Yes, my dear students, in this new textbooks we have various attributes of meta tag, starting with the name attribute. Yes, the value of the name attribute can be related to any of the following. Here we have author name, description, keywords, copyright. So these are a few important attribute values which are related to the name attribute, such as author, description, keywords, or copyright. Example is given, meta name is equal to author, and the brackets are closed. Basically, what this name attribute does is it specifies the name of metadata like author, or the keywords or important points on your web page, or the description of your web page in detail. So this is the name attribute of meta tag. Moving towards the next attribute, it is the content attribute of meta. It can have any textual matter related to the name. As an example, meta name is equal to author, and then the attribute is content. So here you can mention what type of a content or which content you are carrying on your webpage. Here we have put Bal Bharati as the content. So it is very clear that here content of author is Bal Bharati. Similarly, my dear students, there is another example where meta name is equal to description, content is equal to advanced web designing. So hope you are getting it. We also do a practical on it. Don't worry, it is a very simple one. This tag helps you in optimizing the search engines, and thus meta name, description, content, we have specified advanced web designing. So what exactly happens here? The value for content attribute specifies name of the topic, advanced web designing. Very clearly. Then moving on to the next one, next example, meta name is equal to keywords. Yes, content here is HTML5, or we can say learn HTML5 is also a keyword, list in HTML5 is also one of the keywords. So basically, if you go through these two attributes, the one is name and the other one is content, from the name attribute we used all these three over here, that is author, we put Bal Bharati as the content, for description we put advanced web designing, for keywords we used the certain keywords such as HTML5, learn HTML5, list in HTML5. So in this way, my dear students, these two attributes for meta tag shall work. Moving further towards the next few attributes, a very important one, the next one here is the character set. Yes, my dear students, every particular language has a particular character set, and here meta tag helps the search engines to understand the character set we are using. UTF-8 is the most commonly used, or we can say the most regularly used one declaration. Similarly, Big 5 is also a Chinese character. For Chinese character it is used. A syntax for this can be like meta charset is equal to the name of the charset which you are using. Here if we put UTF-8, it means we are specifying for Indian characters, and when we use Big 5, so we are specifying for Chinese characters. So in this way, charset displays the characters which we are going to use with the meta element. So moving on to the next one, HTTP equivalent. Once again, a very important one, and this is the one which helps your web page refresh, or we can say set cookies on it, and content type expires after a certain period of time. So whenever you feel you must have visited, my dear students, on various websites like Facebook, YouTube, always and always regular basis, the background refresh options are always going on. My dear students, here also HTTP equi helps the page to refresh automatically after a certain point. So HTTP equivalent is used basically for HTTP response message headers such as refresh, set cookie, content type and expires, etc. Let us have a certain example of it. Meta HTTP equi is equal to refresh, content is equal to 5. This means after every 5 seconds the page will get refresh. So basically the context or the syntax is very simple. Meta HTTP equi is the attribute, and then we use a particular type, that is refresh, and we are giving the content 5, that is 5 seconds. Similarly, meta HTTP equi is equal to set cookies, will set cookies automatically to the browser. Meta HTTP equi is equal to content type content text, HTML cache set big 5. Now here, my dear students, it is completely back to the server, specifies the character encoding for the document here. As we suggested upwards, big 5 is for Chinese characters. Similarly, meta HTTP equivalent expires when the page expires or when the session of that page expires. Here, user ID is given and the expiring time is given, that is Wednesday, 8 Feb 2018, and a particular time in a particular format is given. So here, page session will get expire at the specified time over here. So in this way, my dear students, it is easy to understand these attributes of the meta tag. Once again, I repeat, my dear students, it is an empty singular tag which carries information within its attributes, and so it is very important to understand the attributes of the meta tag. Once again, my dear students, meta tag is a tag in HTML that describes some aspects of contents of a web page, mostly used by search engines to search information that is provided with the web page. So basically, to search information, search engines use the meta information given by you. So hopefully this topic is clear to you. In the next video lecture, we will do a practical of how to execute the code and use the various attributes of meta tag. Till then, stay safe, stay connected. Thank you very much.